So the next problem of chain surveying we are going to deal with is finding the width of a river. Earlier we have discussed about the different obstacles that we might face during chain survey. So the next obstacle is, suppose we are doing chain survey on the ground, suppose AC is a chain line and we need to continue this line, but we cannot because there is a river in between. Suppose this is a river which is flowing from west to east. This is the north direction, east, west and south. So the direction of the river is, the direction of flow of the river is from west to east. So we need to continue our survey work through this river. In order to do that, what we need to do is that we need to find the width of this river. Then only we can continue our survey work beyond this point. Okay. So what we are doing is that we are selecting one point on this chain line at this end of the bank, and we are selecting another point B on the other bank of the river, but on the same chain line, on the same straight line. Okay, we are selecting one point at this end and we are selecting another point at the other end of the river. Okay, we have continued the line, we have extended the line from A to C. Okay, and then we have drawn one perpendicular offset of any length. We have drawn one perpendicular offset of any length, suppose AD, from the point A. From the point A, we have drawn one perpendicular offset of any measured length, suppose AD. And the next step is that we have drawn another perpendicular offset from the point C, suppose CE. But the criteria is that when we are drawing this perpendicular offset from point C, the criteria is that point B, D and E, these three points have to lie on the same straight line. That means it has to be like this. It has to be like this. So have you understood what we have done here? We have drawn one perpendicular offset from A, suppose AD, and we have drawn the second perpendicular offset from the point C, so that point B, D and E lie on the same straight line. That's what we have done. And the next step is that we have drawn another perpendicular offset from the point D to the line C. Suppose let's name this point F. We have drawn one perpendicular offset DF on this line. Okay. Now you do realize that when we have drawn this perpendicular offset from the point D, DF, then DF becomes parallel to the line AC. Okay. Now what we can find out from this figure is that the triangle ABD, the triangle ABD is similar to the triangle DFE. The triangle ABD. The triangle ABD is similar to the triangle DFE. Okay, this triangle and this triangle are similar. So what we can find out is that from the figure, AB by DF is equal to AD by FE. Clear? So what we need to find out here is that we need to find out AB. So we can easily find out AB from this. AB is equal to AD by FE into DF. So what about FE here? Can we write FE in some other term? What is FE here? This whole length CE minus CF.
So in that way we can write Fe, Ce minus Cf into Df. Okay.